I think out of all forms of art, street art and graffiti is something which has the most direct connection with the people.
I think walls anybody can see. Ek Mercedes wala bhi dekh sakta hai, ek bhikhari ja raha hai, so that he can also admire the artwork.
So that's not something that you get to find in an art gallery. In an art gallery, everybody goes there specifically to see art. But with street art, there's people who are going down, their different walks of life.
I think that's why it's very important to paint in the street.
My name is Ranjit Dahiya. I'm from Haryana, Sonipat. And I came here in 2009. Mumbai mein Bollywood ka ek bahut bada, I think it's a very important subject in Mumbai. So I said, you can't see Bollywood in the Bollywood city. So I thought, why not make this city more Bollywood? I started this project called Bollywood Art Project in 2012. People really connect with the Bollywood. And I met lots of people when they saw my art, they get into the nostalgia. In Mumbai, I painted first mural in 2010 of Amitabh Bachchan mural. It was small, 10 by 10 feet ka mural. But people still like, they appreciated that thing, ki, wow, I mean, somebody painted. And it gave me like some hope ki, like you should, you know, paint more Bollywood in this Bollywood city. Amitabh Bachchan mural, it's on the ceiling. It's India's tallest wall mural. It's a 230 feet height. It was very difficult to paint that mural also. I want to make forgotten heroes jinhone Bollywood ko aaj banaya, the classical Bollywood. So my plan is to paint them more in the street. And I want to paint Bollywood anywhere in the world, wherever Bollywood lovers are.
Hi, my name is Omkar. I'm the co-founder of Wicked Bros and creator of Marol Art Village. The set out here to do is that we want to beautify the space, get as many local contributors and local stakeholders in this and create a street art district here. So that's what we've been on for the past about 6 years now. In March 2019, we organized a street art festival which was the first of its kind. It is called Ladies First Street Art and it's India's first women-only street art festival. The cool part about it was that we had 7 artists come from all over the world. We had artists from New Zealand, from the USA, and a couple of our Indian street artists as well. Well, there are a couple of special pieces, but one of the special pieces here in this neighborhood is that temple that we've painted. So the strange thing about that is before that moment, we had never actually painted a temple, and I didn't even know it was possible to paint a temple. It was really surprising because a foreign artist came and did it, and the locals were so supportive, and they got the ladder, and they helped him out with the lights, and they were helping him out get the paints, get the water, whatever it was. So it was a really nice experience, and that really opened the way for us. I feel that young artists are very enthusiastic for graffiti and street art because it gives them the opportunity to get out in front of the world and get that kind of platform even though they are upcoming artists.
I think it's blooming in India and lots of people are getting very connected with the street art.
I think it's something more inclusive, something where people can directly understand their art and look at the art, and at the end of the day, that's what any artist needs, is maximum eyeballs and different perceptions from different kinds of people.
You can express yourself. So it's, I think it's very good to young people are coming forward and they're also like choosing this profession.
But I think for kids out there who want to move out from the canvas, the only way is to like pick up a brush and pick up a wall. Ever since we are young, we have been taught to not touch the walls. You know, it's always been stick to paper, stick to your books, but don't touch the walls. So that's a major step. And as soon as you paint your first wall, I can assure you it won't be your last wall.